Well, thank you, Mr. Chairman, for that opportunity, and let me salute you and Senator Cardin for not only having this nomination hearing, but for the work you're collectively doing on the Western Hemisphere. And I appreciate Senator Cardin has taken up a lot of the issues that are critical in the hemisphere, and has been a strong champion of many things I care about, as well as that independently to his global leadership on Magnitsky is pursuing in the Western Hemisphere. And let me just say to all the nominees, I appreciate your long service to our country. I'm always thrilled when we see career members of the Foreign Service be nominated for ambassadorships, and these three countries are incredibly important. In a region that largely otherwise is committed to human rights and democracy, for 4 months, the international community has watched in horror as Daniel Ortega and Rosario Murillo have authorized their police and paramilitary groups to wield extreme force against their own citizens, resulting in more than 450 deaths, hundreds in prison, and dozens forcibly disappeared. The administration has rightfully imposed global Magnitsky sanctions on three Nicaragua officials, but I believe stronger action is needed. That's why I introduced bipartisan legislation last month with Senator Rubio to increase targeted sanctions against Nicaraguan officials involved in human rights abuses and efforts to undermine democracy, and I'm pleased that Chairman Corker has agreed to consider our bill. Turning toward Honduras, in recent months, Americans have watched in horror as the Trump administration has adopted an inhumane policy of ripping children from their Honduran and Central American parents at the U.S. border. Moreover, former Secretary Tillerson's deliberate disregard of the expertise of career diplomats in his recommendation to end TPS for Honduras put at risk our national security and the safety of TPS beneficiaries and their U.S. citizen children, something that I join Senator Cardin in hoping that we can find a way to turn the clock back. It is not in the national interest of the United States, or I think of its security, to send people back when our own career diplomatic people tell us that the situation on the ground is not conducive to the return to a large number of those nationals. Additionally, while President Hernandez has been an important U.S. security partner, we must support reform efforts to promote the rule of law and transparency and to confront impunity, notably, as Senator Cardin said, for the 2016 murder of indigenous leader and environmental activist Berta Cáceres and the 24 people killed in protest following last year's election. So I look forward to our nominees' testimony, Mr. Chairman, the opportunity for questions.